Hello everyone, I'm Dr. Francisco. Today we're going to discuss an important topic that is if patients with dialysis or with a kidney transplant can undergo sports or certain exercise, knowing that there are so many types of sports or exercises, then it's very difficult to advise you, you know, one-on-one, no? But I'm just going to talk about the generalities of them. For the specificities, you need to discuss with your own doctor, or you can discuss with me, obviously, if you choose me as your care doctor. Especially that now I'm in association with an exercise physiologist and a rehab team. So like to try to deliver, you know, better lifestyle and care to our patients, yeah? So let's start. The question is, can you practice sports or any exercise even if undergoing dialysis or a kidney transplant? You know, the answer is going to be yes, no? But there will be few details and few individualizations that need to be done for every case, no? For people who practice sports, sports are actually an important part of the lifestyle, and continuing doing them, it's an important part of their general well-being. One of the aims of undergoing dialysis and, more importantly, kidney transplantation is to allow as much as possible a close to normal life to the patients. Not just to be alive, but to live your life. And for many patients, it is very important to do exercise, to practice sports. And for those that is not important, it should be maybe, if they want to practice sports, cool, if not. But, you know, remaining active, have an active lifestyle, introduce some exercise as much or as many their condition allows them. It is ideal for the general well-being to improve the metabolism, you know, strengthen the heart, etc. And as I always repeated, you can already say it. What I always say is those patients that I have encountered who live a more frugal life regarding diet and have a more active lifestyle and take good care of themselves, try to have a positive mind, living life as normal as possible, they tend to do better and live longer and better than patients that decide not to take good care of the diet, to not to remain active, to succumb psychologically to the diagnosis. Like, indeed, it's a severe disease, severe complications, significant meaning in someone's dreams, goals, expectations from life, but still something more can be done if we accept it and approach it with a more positive mindset and proactive actions. Yeah. So in a way, exercise, some exercises are good for you, but obviously if you have been the condition, if you are not used to this, or your health might not be that great, especially if you have kidney failure, etc. You want to introduce some exercises, or you have some body limitations, injuries, it's ideal that you consult your doctor first, and together with a physiotherapist that can give you the set of exercises more suitable for your condition and also for your goals, no? There are people that are on a kidney transplant and still running even marathons or things like that. So many things can be achieved or and are possible if you decide to take good care of yourself and if your disease doesn't get complicated, no? Because sometimes even that you do many things, the disease still progresses, etc., no? Well, definitely, if self-care is not one of the priorities, everything is going to go is most likely to happen, etc. So let me see this again. Yes, by self-care. Otherwise, indeed, diseases, complications can come easily. So in a way, if you have a transplant or dialysis, the aim is to try to rehabilitate you to try to live a life as normal as possible. But indeed, you might need to take some precautions and to adapt to your new vitality, strength, and health. And although I say it can be done, certainly depends on the type of sports, its intensity, and its level of competitivity. You know, for instance, wrestling, American football, or rugby, you know, will be probably difficult to do if you have a kidney transplant, you know, because kidney transplant is on the lower abdomen, above the pelvis, so it's sort of exposed. So you wouldn't like to hit it, bruise it, or something like that. So in a way, for that it's a little bit more difficult. Or also you have peritoneal dialysis, or you have because the catheter can be pulled accidentally, no? Or you have hemodialysis through a chest catheter, you know, maybe someone pulls you and pulls your catheter, so that would be too dangerous. So indeed, there might be sports that are not possible. People who know me, you know, I had a football injury, I ruptured my hamstring tendon. After that, that meant no competitive football for me, no competitive races. But that didn't mean no sports for me, no doing exercise. I run, go to the gym, I rock climbing, play with my children, swim, cycle. I can still do other things, but there are things that you just need to accept it and carry on. So for that, it will be difficult, even if it's your passion. For me, football, I mean, tremendous passion, but for that, I didn't settle, I didn't give up, it's just simply now it's not really possible having a ruptured hamstring, you know, you cannot sprint. So you have these conditions, indeed, even if your passion doing rugby, so it will be a little bit tough, but you can still, you know, be a coach of rugby, that's a different story, yeah? So in a way you can circumvent life, for example, football, soccer, you know, the beautiful game, and basketball, also will have some risk, but probably will be a little bit lesser than those, no? Especially where you play competitive football, probably. But if you play football, I play football with my children, so, or with other children, where with my children, so in a way, the risk is probably minimal. It's more risk for your legs if you play against children, but you can still do, but you need to take your reasonable precautions, you know, just need to be strategic and smart about it. But it will be less risk than the other sports, no? But also depends on how intensive, no? How demanding or competitive you want to be, you know? Or who you play with, no? So you play with your children or you play with, you know, a guy in your neighborhood who wants to defeat you, so it's probably not the best idea, no? But if it is just for leisure, no, as I told you, no harm kicking the ball around with your family and friends. Obviously, after all the surgical wounds, internal and external, have healed and recovered. For that, you need to ask your surgeon what is the best period for surgery. Indeed, there are more hardcore, doctors that say, oh no, you should not do sports and you should not do even swimming and things like that, especially if you have a transplant, infection, etc. Swimming would be more difficult if you have a peritoneal dialysis catheter or you have a catheter here. You can defer for a while. As I told you, in transplantation, some doctors are concerned about infections and tell the doctors not to swim, but the reality is many patients with transplant swim. So, mind if you're going to swim in a pond, but if you are going to swim your pool that you know is clean, etc., So the risk might not be that heightened. I've seen so many patients that continue. As I told you, the aim of transplantation is even to get a better rehabilitation. Assuming it's important, it's possible, no? So non-contact sports like badminton, ping pong, obviously are more likely to be done with no issue, no? Also, other forms of exercise like brisk walking, running, or jogging and cycling are really risky. Indeed, you can fall from the bicycle, but even if you don't have a transplant, you fall from risk, you can still, something bad can happen to you. I mean, but it's not like you are going to be in a heightened risk for having a kidney transplant or having a... I have a patient with a transplant that they cycle around, for example, Singapore, and after, continuing the exercise, they feel better, and even though, no, they should not do it, and I mean, it's part of the well-being, and they feel better. Also, they feel stronger, more satisfied. But you just need to take your precautions, no? Because there are so many sports I already mentioned, and exercise types, and permutations of all that. Obviously, I cannot give you advice for all of them or what matches better certain therapies. But you can ask your doctor. If someone asks me the question, hey, doc, what do you think about me practicing rugby? Then I can tell them something. What do you think about me practicing bowling or rock climbing? Then we can talk more specifically, no? So one of the tenets of renal replacement therapy, as I told you, either through dialysis or transplantation, is to allow you to live your life as normal as possible. So if sports and exercise are important to you, and indeed keeping an active lifestyle, it is beneficial, obviously. You just need to do it with some adjustment. An idea under the advice of a doctor or a physiotherapist. In Francisco Kidney Medical Center, we can advise you more specifically and accurately about that, because apart from being a kidney doctor, I'm also a health coach. I have a health enhancement and weight loss program. And many of my kidney patients are actually clients also in my health enhancement and weight loss program, where diet, self-care, better, healthier diet, a more active lifestyle, a more positive mindset, acquiring better habits, getting rid of bad habits like smoking is the core. But we just support them, walk hand in hand with them, etc. So we this is also our specialty in Francisco Kidney Medical Center, and in my other company it's called Olympia Lifestyle. So actually I can make this, if you want to try to not all the focus is in the care of your kidney, you want to probably improve your health as a whole, your metabolic control, you want to probably lose weight, you want to introduce more exercise or try to eat better, you can consider also joining my other Facebook group. It's called Health Enhancement and Weight Loss Olympia Lifestyle by Dr. Francisco. I can put the link later on the... You don't need to just want to get fit for, etc. Many of my kidney patients, middle age, etc. or more, they also have been clients of my Olympian lifestyle, because when I see a patient, as I told you, always a lot in the mindset, proactive, self-care, etc. I always try to see them as a whole person and beyond that, no? The disease affects also the mindset, of affects their loved ones, affairs, their work, etc. I try to go beyond and advise them beyond just the typical medications for kidney, go for dialysis, go for transplant, etc. And at the end, also, if they go for certain treatments, certain therapies, if they improve other aspects of their life, definitely they are going to do much better. And because I want the best for them, so I always advise them on every single aspect. If I see the cholesterol high, I advise them on that. I see the uric acid, the sugar not very well controlled, I see a tummy, I see that you smoke, I always say something because I care about their well-being, and it will be good for them. We just don't need to focus only on a disease. And actually, in many occasions, especially for kidney problems, those things that have not been well set in a lifestyle, in a diet, and on those habits, is actually what in many occasions led to the disease of the kidney itself, or heart disease, etc., or make it worse. Even that someone has already kidney problem, taking care of all those variables is actually better for their health. And because of that, I know that what I have observed, that if you live a more active lifestyle, eat better, eat more nutritious food, etc., my patients tend to live longer and better than those patients that have chosen not to do it. No. We have some comments. We'll discuss in a minute. Okay. According to your medical conditions. Okay. So in Francisco Clinical Center, we help you with that. Also, we have a rehab associate that can see a physiotherapist, and we have an extra physiologist that can see our patients as well. We are associates. We are in discussions to try to see if we can improve this as well. So also for yourself, don't think that you see the cardiologist for your heart, you see the kidney doctor for this, no? And then you forget about the rest of your body, no? When everything is interconnected, and actually focusing in the whole body, it will make everything better and minimize complications, etc. But when we fraction that, or you just say, okay, oh no, I just want to focus in my heart and in my kidney because my doctor told me I have a heart disease, and because just focus on the labels, when I'm seeing what is going on in the whole, in the mind, in the body, in the diet, lifestyle, etc., is when we leave things unsettled, and these things keep building up and eventually turn into a complication or to a problem. No, that is my invitation to consider that. In Francisco Kidney Center, we are not just a kidney clinic. We are also a medical clinic that see many of these related problems. And we also go beyond into health. And one of the principles of my two companies is prevention. It is better than cure. If I show to, too like insistive on self-care, if I sound too pushy on that, is because is what works better. What I have seen it, what is actually, and because I want the best for you. So, but has to start from your own self. So that's why I am too pushy too enthusiastic. I'm not going to push it because I don't push anyone. I just enthusiastically, passionately encourage people to consider taking care of the whole self, mind, body, and occasional spirit as well. So, but we have the tools for the kidney, we have the tools for physio, diet, etc. So you need our advice, you can contact us. Okay, let me see, there is a couple of comments. Okay, there someone is sharing about being a peritoneal dialysis, if you're watching me. So have itching and pain on the bones. You know, itching is part of the symptoms of kidney failure. And, you know, bone aches are also some of the symptoms. So what will be ideal is to, you know, sometimes you can give symptomatic medications for itching. Maybe you are taking, if not, your doctor, your nurses can advise you on that. The pain of the bone, sometimes painkillers can help. Sometimes there might be some derangements in the mineral metabolism, part of the kidney disease. I don't know, sometimes the phosphate could be very high, the IPTH is high, meaning your bones being resorbed more than normal, and that can come some aches and other issues. So that would have to be, in your case, explore in more detail. Yeah, so maybe you need to discuss those symptoms with your doctor wherever you are in the world, to advise you in more detail. Probably you will need to contact me separately, and you can send me a messenger. But indeed, those are symptoms, and sometimes something can be done about them. In occasions, might be a problem of the mirror metabolism, you know, and when you start into more balance with medications, but actually going back to diet, many of these mineral metabolism issues in patients with kidney failure, they will be simpler and better treated if many of the patients will more concordant with the diet restrictions. Indeed, they are very unpalatable diet restrictions. They will be very unpalatable diet restrictions, but if the patients start controlling their phosphate better, so sometimes many of those symptoms improve, and the IPTH will get better. So, like, in a way, if we don't rely only on medications, but at the same time, medications plus diet, everything works better. So, obviously, to give you most accurate advice, I will need to probably assess you properly, because you mentioned that you're in Cape Town, so it's a bit tougher. But you just flag those symptoms to your own doctor. Yeah. If there is no any question regarding the topic of today, that is more exercise for kidney failure, but I guess obviously if you have some aches, etc., it's more difficult to do exercise. But you know, in the dialysis center, so I'm working as a visiting consultant in the National Kidney Foundation in Singapore, and in there they have exercise programs. So in the on the TVs, they, or sometimes some nurses, maybe with the COVID now, no, like kind of show the patients to do exercise. When they are in the chair, they move the arms, they move the legs, they move the neck, etc. Some stretching, some movements, that's good enough. If you can just do also at home. So that's why people with symptoms like bone pain, etc., will be more difficult to indeed you play sports. But by trying to tackle what is the issue that you can only probably do it with your own doctor, and with the advice from an experienced physiotherapist, etc., can prescribe you some exercises that are doable for your condition. That's the role of the rehab, the physiotherapist people, like to try to tailor exercises to your physical or medical capabilities. No, so I just simply wish your condition gets better, or try to get to the bottom of the problem. It might be around that area. Your doctor with all the blood work can probably advise you better, but just flag to them. So many of my, what I also want through this group is that you all have, the battery is going to die soon. Let me just charge it. I'm going to finish soon, but the main aim of this group, and that's why I created, I mentioned the other day, is because many patients don't have some information. The doctors have busy clinics and don't tell them this information, or sometimes rely on not very trustable sources of the internet. So I try to give you all this information so at least you know that what could be going on, or at least you have the curiosity, or at least you probably have some elements to ask your doctor. One of the aims also this is just give you that, and this is just the minimum. I just hoping to create an inquisitive mind at the end for your benefit, for better care. Now you can say, hey doc, you know, by the way, you don't have these pains, maybe Could we check that? Or hey doc, I heard on the internet this internet doctor from Singapore, like talking about transplantation. Can you tell me more about it? So is what I want to do with this. But obviously, if any one of you want my opinion, you will need probably to contract me formally as a patient, so like to give you the best possible advice. But if not, at least I just trigger some inquisitive mind or some discussion with your own doctor, and then your own doctor can really solve all your problems and all your queries now specifically to you, no? Because I'm just giving you the generalities. I want you to know and use that to eventually treat your disease better or discuss better with your doctor. When you discuss better with your doctor, you have more clarity what needs to be done, you have more clarity what is going on, so you can accept it and move on and keep on and try to live your life as best as possible, as normal as possible, as I always encourage you and wish for yourself. So that's in a nutshell today's topic. Sorry once more for the delay, but I was busy with a patient. That's it. So Dr. Francisco, wishing you the best possible health. Take care. Bye-bye.